I'd like to start with a show of hands. So how many of you out there would be willing to take with your loved ones a commercial airline flight? If you could raise your hands. Willing to take a commercial airline flight. Okay, so the majority of the room, great. How many of you would be willing to take that same commercial airline flight if there were no human pilot? There are data analytics, there is excellent automated pilot, all of the science that the airline industry has, but there's not a human pilot in the cockpit. How many of you would be willing to take that flight? Okay, look at that, right? So Tesla owners who are ready for the next step, lovely. That's a couple people, not bad, maybe 10. How many of you would be willing to take that same commercial airline flight with your loved ones if there was a human pilot experienced, they had done this for years, and no data analytics, no autopilot, just the pilot, their experience, and the horizon? Okay, we have a few hands there. I think you guys all probably have pilot licenses, so good for you. This is the future of medicine. What we're going to see in the future of healthcare is that by 2030, when we go and we engage in the healthcare system, when we see our clinician, we are going to expect, no, we are going to demand that we see a human that we can interact with clinical acumen, and a human that is working with artificial intelligence to ensure that all the data that is out there in science is being used to help us achieve the best outcome. And that's what's coming. My name is Dr. Ami Bhatt. I'm a boots on the ground cardiologist turned chief innovation officer just about a year ago. And I'd love to teach you today about the idea of collaborative intelligence. When we think about collaborative intelligence, what do we mean? So as we work as clinicians, one of the things we recognize is that we used to have all the data in our heads. We had all the knowledge from the books in our head, and our patient relied on that. But when you think about data today, there is so much more that is out there that we are actually unable to know all of it. Collaborative intelligence is the opportunity for us to take all the data that is there, and when I say us, I mean you as individuals and us as clinicians, and accept that that data can be analyzed and that the AI output can then be iterated upon between you, your clinician, and that AI output to decide what is best for you. So how does this work, actually? What happens is the following. The artificial intelligence uncovers what humans are unable to see clearly, but it only offers it up for assessment. Hey, doc, I noticed this pattern. What do you think? That's all we're doing. So the intelligence remains ours. I'd like to give you three examples of how this actually could work today. Today, I could do the following for you. Let's start in the hospital. So if you have a loved one, go to the hospital. It is likely that they will get an imaging study. We'll take a picture of some part of their body. And when we do that, a doctor like me will sit in a quiet room and we will have the imaging studies pushed to our screen and we will read them and we will interpret them. Today, with collaborative intelligence, what we're able to do is while I am reading that first study of the day, the AI is rank ordering every single image that is coming in. And so the next thing I read will be the sickest patient in the hospital. And that will continue throughout the day. What happens? That enables me to call the floor and say, hey, this person's really sick, and they can move earlier on them. They're not just going in order of when something got to me. We are helping the sickest patient first. And we're doing that all day long, and ideally, we're maybe even saving some lives. It's also helpful to me as a clinician, because by the time I get to my 22nd reading of the day, I'm just not as good. The human brain gets tired. And so actually, it's really good for me because I know that I did great things in the morning when I was fresh. And when I got to the end of the day, and I know when I'm not as good, they're easier studies. And so this is a win-win for the patients and for physicians who, as we discussed earlier, are leaving the clinical workforce because of how difficult it is. Now, let's leave the hospital. Let's go to your home. So in your home, you may have a smartwatch or a wearable. You may have a blood pressure cuff that you use. You may have a weight scale you get on or a temperature for your children. You may even have an implanted remote monitoring device or something that was prescribed for you. And all of this can give you continuous data, but right now, we see you episodically. We see you once a year. And when we see you once a year, we pick a number. Let's take blood pressure, since I'm a cardiologist. And we say, this is an ideal blood pressure. Well, it turns out that for each of us in here, over the 100 of us in here, we all have a different range for heart rate, for blood pressure, pick any parameter. We all have a unique range. Now picture, with collaborative intelligence today, I know your range because it is being monitored continuously. And when the AI notices that you are out of your own personal range, that is when I am alerted. That is when I come to you and I say, hey, is there something going on? We should probably talk about this. And that's what I want to do, because even though I would love to treat you, I would love to prevent disease in you or catch you earlier. I would love that even better. Now, there may be times where whatever the alert is wrong, and that's okay. We don't need to throw out the AI, but we need to be willing as patients and as doctors to work with the AI to make it better, to work with that AI and collaborate with it so that we can get it right for you, so we pick up the right signal at the right time. We'll end in a third place. Let's actually end in the office. Right? This is where I started. So actually, I started in a two-bedroom apartment where the kitchen was the room we used for the EKG machine, and there was a very nice 82-year-old woman, Sharon. She's very slow, meticulous, but did really nice EKGs. I don't think she would even understand how quickly we can get an EKG today. But that's where we started. And I had time with my patients. They came in, we sat, we faced each other, we chatted. I knew the data, I knew their history. Fast forward to today, just the sheer number of patients that need to be seen that are waiting to get in, and then the numerous silos of data. There's the wearable data we just talked about. There's your electronic health record. There's probably some messages that you sent my nurse and myself since the last time I saw you. There's the guidelines on your specific diseases. And then there's the research that has happened since those guidelines that's really high-end cutting research that would be important for me to know about you, but we don't update the guidelines fast enough for all of that to get in. If I wanted to get all that data, I could spend the entire appointment facing the computer, trying to get all that data, and I still wouldn't succeed. So I wouldn't be able to give you everything that's available, the scientific rigor that is appropriate for your care. But with collaborative intelligence, I could get that on my iPhone, I could get that as a printout. I could still use the computer and look up more, nothing's limiting me. But now I can turn and face you, and we can have a human-to-human interaction. And with collaborative intelligence, I know so much more about you than I would have otherwise. And you and I get to be connected again the way it used to be in the two-bedroom apartment with the EKG in the kitchen. And so it really brings us back to where we want to be, collaborative intelligence. So I'm going to end with this. He's my hero. Healthcare today has such promise. And yet a lot of the time it kind of feels like we're in shambles. And that's because we've outdone ourselves. There is more data available for us to assess than the human brain can do in a doctor-patient interaction. However, if we think about this, have others buy in, and create the infrastructure, like the pilot has in his cockpit, if we create the infrastructure where we can use collaborative intelligence, if we can harness the power of AI and still remember, recognize, and believe that the intelligence is ours, then each and every one of us in here can avail ourselves of all the possibilities of what healthcare can do today. Thank you.